सो वेलकम गाइज, आवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज हाउ टू पिक स्टॉक्स फॉर स्विंग ट्रेडिंग इन जस्ट 5 मिनट्स पर डे. सो इन दिस वेबिनार आई विल शो यू यू कैन ऑल्सो पिक अ स्टॉक फॉर स्विंग ट्रेडिंग. स्विंग ट्रेडिंग मीन्स यू नीड टू बाई टूडे और यू नीड टू शॉर्ट सेल टूडे एंड यू कैन होल्ड योर पोजिशन फॉर नेक्स्ट 1 डे, 2 डे और 5 डेज और 10 डेज. सो स्विंग ट्रेडिंग is not a intraday kind of trading. You need to buy today and you need to sell within next few days. So, and this technique does not require a lot of time to be invested. You can just give 5 minutes, 10 minutes or 15 minutes per day and you can find a rocking stock. You can find a rocking stock that can give you decent return. Decent return means the return can be 2% to 5% or 10%. It is a decent kind of return and this technique is also having quite good accuracy. So before I go into the deep of the webinar, just a short intro of mine. I am Indrajit Mukherjee. I am the founder of stockmaniacs.net. So those who have not visited my site, you can visit my site at stockmaniacs.net. This is the site address. stockmaniacs.net. Before leaving the webinar, you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. To subscribe me, just hit the subscribe button and you can get my next video updates instantly. Or you can also join my trading team. To join me, just WhatsApp me your name, phone number and email ID to +91 96743 21856. I'll just repeat the WhatsApp number. It is +91 96743 21856. So let us come to the topic. In this short webinar, I'll show you you can find out a good stock within few minutes a day. So let us start. So this is my site. We have many tools for the traders here. So I'll show you how to use a simple charting tool to find out the rocking stock, to find out the stock that will give you a decent return within next few days. So you need to log in to stockmaniacs.net, S-T-O-C-K stock, M-A-N-I-A-C-S, stockmaniacs.net. Come here. Once you join here, under the freebies, there are free charts. So you need to concentrate on these three links. So this is Nifty 50 EOD. That means these are the charts of Nifty 50 stocks, and EOD means end of day charts. So all Nifty 50 stocks end of day charts are here. The next is Junior Nifty EOD. So this is the all the stocks charts. Those are into Junior Nifty or Nifty Next 50 index. And the third one is Midcap 50 EOD. So these are the stocks. Those are into the Midcap 50 index. So let us open the Nifty 50 EOD chart. So the charts are opening. Let us give some time to open the page completely. So the page is opened. So we can see here are the charts. First chart is Nifty 50 Nifty index daily chart. Next one is Nifty index weekly chart. The third one is Bank Nifty index daily chart. Fourth one is Bank Nifty weekly chart. Then the CNX IT index daily chart, CNX IT index weekly chart. Then the VIX chart, and then the Nifty components. Adani Ports, Asian Paint, Axis Bank and so on till Z Entertainment Limited. So these are all Nifty 50 stocks. So now, as we are seeing that in these charts, we are having a candlestick chart over here. The Bollinger Band has been shown. Plus, there are some moving averages. We are having exponential moving average 5. And we have 50 simple moving average and exponential moving average 20. So these three moving averages are there, plus there are three indicators on the below. One is MACD or moving average convergence divergence. The other two are slow stochastics and RSI. So now we are mainly concerned about the RSI. This is the RSI indicator, relative strength index, and we are having a special value of RSI. We are having the value of 2. So 2 period RSI, this is 2 period RSI. So RSI has been, the period has been decreased so that we can find out the extreme position, extreme short term position of the RSI. So we will consider RSI above 90 as overbought and RSI below 10 as oversold. So, and we will also consider RSI above 95 as extremely overbought and RSI below 5 as extremely oversold. So anytime RSI at oversold or extremely oversold position, chances are that the stock can bounce suddenly. And anytime RSI is overbought or extremely overbought, chances are there that the stock can correct a lot. And these corrections or bounces generally lasts for 2 to 3 days, and you can get out of the trade very fast. So now we will try to find out a stock with a RSI in extreme condition. So let us scroll in the page. We need to find out a stock with RSI less than 90 or with RSI greater than 90 or less than 10. Let us try to find out. Here in Bajaj Finserv, the RSI is almost above 90. Let us find some more. Yeah, this is Bharat Heavy Electricals. The RSI setup is not yet. Yeah, we have got Bajaj Finance Limited. Bajaj Finance, the RSI is above 95. But see, the problem is that the Bajaj Finance is a bullish stock. How I have found out that Bajaj Finance is bullish? Because Bajaj Finance, you can see the EMA setup. Bajaj Finance is above 50 DMA. Bajaj Finance is above 20 DMA. Bajaj Finance is above, the closing price is above 5 DMA. So it is an extremely bullish stock. So though the RSI is above 95, we will not short Bajaj Finance. What we will, the trading strategy is that we will try to find out a bearish stock. As if you can see that Bharat Heavy Electricals is a bearish stock. The left hand side, Bharat Heavy Electricals is a bearish stock because it is moving below the 50 DMA. But Bajaj Finance is a bullish stock because it is moving above the 50 DMA. So we will try to find out a RSI bounce on a bearish stock, and we will try to find out a RSI dip in a bullish stock. So let us find some more. Bharti Airtel, RSI is at midpoint. Cipla is almost, it is very close to 50 DMA. So we'll try to avoid that. Close to 50 DMA, we'll try to avoid that. Once again, Dr. Reddy's, it is just crossed 50 DMA. Though the RSI is overbought, extremely overbought. So this is HCL Technologies, almost in the overbought zone. You can watch Bharti Infratel. Bharti Infratel is a bearish stock, but the RSI has not yet become overbought. So these kind of these trading setups, you need to monitor these kind of stocks. So I am finding out which stock is meeting the criteria. This stock, Tata Motors Limited. You can see Tata Motors, the stock is trading below 50 DMA. The 50 DMA is having a descent down downward slope. So the trend is down, and you can see the RSI 2 is at 96.77. So the RSI 2 is extremely overbought. So you can try a short in the Tata Motors. Let us see the actual scenario of Tata Motors today. It was yesterday's close. Today is Monday. It was last Friday's close. So let us start watching Tata Motors. Let us add Tata Motors in our chart. You can see Tata Motors is at 311.70, 311-312 zone. So Tata Motors is a shorting candidate. You can short sell Tata Motors. And how to exit the stock? You need to short sell in future and options. You need to short sell in futures, and you need to hold till the exit. The exit criteria is you need to wait till the RSI 2, the 2 period RSI comes below 40 zone. So RSI 2 below 40 or 30, you just exit the short. So it is a defined entry and defined exit. So anytime try to find out a bearish stock, wait till the RSI is above 95. That is the best shorting condition. The more the RSI, the better. If the RSI is above 98, it is super. And then wait for the RSI to dip below 40. 40 or 30. 30 is a bit late exit. So 40 is a good exit. So whenever RSI once again drops below the 40 mark, you need to exit the short trade. So simply short sell Tata Motors in futures and wait for the RSI to dip below the 40 zone. You can find out the RSI readings here actually. So current reading of Tata Motors RSI is 96.77. So it is on the extremely overbought zone. Let us see some other stocks. You can find out a stock very fast. So all the stocks charts are given there. So within few minutes you can find out. So we have found out Tata Motors within few minutes. So I am writing fast stock Tata Motors. Tata Motors short sell. So there are other two pages. I'll also see what are the condition in the junior Nifty EOD. Let us give some time to get the charts loaded. Yeah, so the page is opened. Once again, we need to find out a bearish stock with a high RSI reading or a bullish stock with a low RSI reading. And if you do not find the stock with a very high RSI reading, if you found that the RSI is close to the overbought zone, you need to monitor the stock. Once again, monitor the same stock next day. If you found it overbought or most overbought, you need to short sell. Similar is the case for bullish stocks. If you found the RSI is approaching to the oversold zone, you need to start monitoring the stock. another stock here we found, it is Aurobindo Pharma. Aurobindo Pharma, we are seeing that Aurobindo Pharma is a bearish stock because the 50 DMA, the stock is moving below 50 DMA, and we are seeing that the RSI is extremely overbought, so 96.30. so it was Friday's close. So what you need to do, you need to, if you found that the RSI is overbought and the stock is bearish, you need to short sell on Monday morning. So today it is almost 1:30 in the afternoon, so you need to short sell in the Monday morning, and you need to hold till the price, till the RSI comes below 40. So Aurob Pharma, you can see the price is at 574 rupees. So once again we'll find out Aurob Pharma short sell. So the entry exit criteria is very simple. You need to just short sell, and you need to wait till the RSI dips below 40. For a buy setup, you need to just buy if the RSI is below 10 or best below 5 or super below 2, and you need to wait till the RSI crosses 60 mark on the upside. So I'll just write the strategy over here. Buy RSI below 10 or best below 5, bullish stock plus RSI below 10 or best below 5, sell RSI process 60, short sell bearish stock plus RSI above 90 or best above 95, cover RSI crosses 40. So these are the criteria. So once again I am telling you that the bullish criteria, stock above 50 DMA, bearish criteria, stock below 50 DMA, and the DMA slope also matters. If the DMA is sloping upwards, the trend is up. If the DMA is sloping downwards, the trend is down. So this is a very simple strategy. You can find out stocks very easily. The entry and exit is defined. No need to keep a stop loss. Whenever the price, whenever the RSI actually crosses certain levels, you need to exit. So and we have backtested this strategy also. It is having a quite high accuracy. The accuracy is as high as above 80%. So no need to keep a stop loss. You need to entry as per the RSI, and you need to exit as per the RSI. Another thing you need to remember, those who will tell that this strategy is not having a stop loss. See, basically we are entering and exiting on the basis of an indicator. So believe the system, believe the indicator. Do not mix and match a stop loss and all, because if you keep a stop loss, many times you will find out that the stop loss will get hit, and after that the stock will come down or move up. So this is a very defined strategy. Once again, it proves that you can pick a stock for swing trading. So this is a, you need to hold the position for next few days. This is basically a FNO trade. You need to buy in future or you need to short in future. And you can find out a stock within just 5 minutes a day. So I'll just conclude here. The criteria is that you need to find out a stock well above 50 DMA to buy, and you need to find a stock well below 50 DMA to sell, and the 50 DMA slope matters. Here in Aurobindo Pharma, you can see the 50 DMA slope is flat. So here I'll prefer the other one, Tata Motors, above Aurobindo Pharma. So if I am shorting Aurobindo Pharma, I'll be shorting Aurobindo Pharma in lower quantity. But if I am shorting Tata Motors, I'll short Tata Motors in a higher quantity. So let us find some more stocks. This is overbought. Cadila Healthcare is overbought, but not yet extremely overbought. Yeah, this is overbought. Emami Limited is overbought 95.92, but as the stock, as the price is close to 50 DMA, we'll avoid this. So close to 50 DMA, you need to avoid. The stock should be away from 50 DMA. So this is how you can find out a stock very easily. So just remember, just bookmark this site, stockmaniacs.net, and here under the freebies, under the free charts, just keep your mouse on freebies. Just there are free charts, and under the free charts there are EOD charts. So Nifty 50 EOD, Junior Nifty EOD, and Mid Cap 50 EOD. So these three will show you the charts of Nifty 50 index, all the stocks under Nifty 50 index, all the stocks under Junior Nifty index, and all the stocks under Mid Cap 50 index. So within very short time, you can find out a tradable stock from these 15 to 3, that means 150 stocks. So this concluded my webinar. I have already shown you the stock picking criteria. Just to conclude, before the webinar ends, if you liked my webinar, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just hit the subscribe button before you leave the webinar. Or if you want to join my trading team, you can do so by opening a trading and demat account under me. For that, simply WhatsApp me your name, phone number and email ID and send it to +91 96743 21856. I'll just repeat the WhatsApp number once again. It is +91 96743 21856. So friends, we have seen how to pick stocks for swing trading in just 5 minutes per day. If you have any questions, any kind of questions, you can ask me in the comment section below the video. I love to answer your comments. Thanks a lot for joining my webinar once again. Bye bye.